When working with large, complex systems, issues might appear at specific times in a simulation. How do you localize the problem to debug it faster? Model Slicer helps you manage and debug large models by selecting signals and time windows of interest and then highlighting the related model construct. In this video, we present how to use Model Slicer to debug a baseline test failure with Simulink test. In this fuel controller system, we launch the Simulink test app and then launch the test manager. There is a baseline test that we can run in debug mode. This test compares simulation outputs to a fixed baseline. Three signals have failed. Let's look at the results of the fuel signal in the simulation data inspector that shows the differences versus the baseline. We can use the debug option to enter debug mode. From here, we launch Model Slicer. This will set up the debug environment. The test case is rerun to create new debug results to make sure the failure still exists in the current state of the model. The failed signal is automatically plotted in the debugging results and set as a starting point for Model Slicer. The simulation pauses at the model start time to continue debugging. The model components that impact the failed signal are highlighted for each time step. You can use the step back and step forward buttons to move one step back or forward in simulation time. For each step, the data dependencies are highlighted and the port value labels for the active signals are updated. In the test manager, we'll click Continue to Failure to continue the model simulation to the beginning of the next failure point. The data cursors show the bounds of the failure region. At the failure, the difference between the baseline and sim output is 0.007. By tracing the fuel signal back in the model, we see that it depends on the two-plant subsystem. Inspecting the two-plant subsystem, there's no change in the value being propagated. So let's look further back at the fuel rate control. So we can see that the FB correction value is zero, and the difference between the baseline and sim output is a very small value. It might be that the FB correction is not being calculated correctly. In the airflow calc block, we can see that the constant zero is being passed through the integrator switch block because the control port is evaluating to false. To see why this is false, we can turn on highlighting of control dependencies. This tells us that fuel mode value is low, but the fuel mode is being compared to the enumerated constant value of rich. So this is the problem. This should be low. So now I'll exit debug mode and make the change to the model, and then rerun the test. And now we see it passes. The Model Slicer helped us isolate the cause of the error and fix it. To learn more or to request a trial of Simulink Check and Simulink Test, please visit our website.